Alright, good morning, good evening, or whatever time it is where you are right now. Give me just 1 second, I'll have to adjust some settings. Right here now, I'm fully ready. Yeah, once again, welcome everyone. Today we're going to take the first steps to creating a new open source plugin for Adobe XD using some of the new features. The latest features actually that got added to the APIs just a few days ago. More specifically, I'm currently planning to use the responsive resize layout constraint API features we now have to maybe add some shortcuts to controlling these constraints a bit more easily. And I'll just switch over so you can see my screen. Right now I have the documentation for these new features open here in the official Adobe XD plugin documentation, so adobexdplatform.com/plugin-docs. And here we have CNode horizontal constraints, and below that the CNode vertical constraints. There's also a boolean of has custom constraints, and we can also reset a node to have the automatic constraints once again. I've also already set up a repository on GitHub for this project. This is forked from my XD plugin boilerplate, which I always use for my plugins. It's an MIT licensed open source project in my GitHub profile, which you can just use as a template and build your plugins with that. And that's what I'm going to do here today. I'm not quite sure as of yet what the plugin will actually do, so we'll just have to take a look at that as we go along. I'm also quite unsure how far we'll get there today, but yeah, we'll just begin, work a bit on it. It's already kind of late where I am right now, so it's 10 o'clock in the evening, so I'm probably not going to now make a 4-hour stream of this, but maybe 1 or 2 hours of just taking the first steps of developing the plugin, and then we can continue with this process later on in the next few days, or whenever it is I'll next find some time to do it. First of all, of course, before we can begin using a plugin, creating a plugin, it is quite useful to at least create some prototype of how this plugin might work. And so I already have a document open inside Adobe XD. I'm going to name it, say, constraint setter plugin. And this will be very low fidelity because, as I've said, this will be a very quick prototype of what we might want to do here. So just some arbitrary grid size that will hopefully work kind of well. 60 looks about right, so we just have some grid to orient everything upon. And as I've said, this will be very low fidelity, very prototype-y in a sense. What I'm planning on doing is, because setting layout constraints is kind, at least in the way I imagine it to be, with keyboard shortcuts, is a very action-based plugin. So it's not like you need persistent UI for that, because you already have persistent UI for that right inside Adobe XD, right here in this right panel. So we don't need a panel plugin for that, frankly, but we'll just use a dialog or modal-based plugin, which you can open with a keyboard shortcut, and upon opening it, you can use some keyboard shortcuts to set all these constraints you already have here on the right side, and then maybe by pressing enter or something like that, you can just close the modal back, close the modal and apply these changes to whatever nodes you had selected. So that or whatever nodes support this that you had selected. So that's the plan. So naturally, a modal dialog will always have probably two buttons. One will be for submitting or confirming the action you want to do. So for example, apply, because you then apply these layout constraints. And this should probably also be the action that gets triggered when you press enter. And because every modal, according to first of all common sense, but also the official UX guidelines for plugins for Adobe XD, say they have to do to be able to, should be cancelable. So yeah, just adding a cancel button right here to at least fulfill these two requirements already. Now just aligning this. Then we will need some sort of headline at the top. So we'll just say constraint or adjust constraints. Again, all of this is just very early prototyping right here. Then we might want to have some small descriptive text about how the plugin works. I'm going to use, and this is advertisement, by the way, my free Lorem Ipsum plugin, so it's not really that much of an advertisement, but that's also another open source plugin I've hosted on GitHub. So so I'll probably use some things I already have in there, just so you're aware. And this didn't quite scale as I expected it to. Let's quickly make these groups and move both of them down. No, not. I want to move the whole groups. And then we need some sort of UI to basically adjust how we can adjust the layout constraints in this plugin. So let's first of all do a bit of experimentation right here of what is possible to do with the layout constraints inside Adobe XD. I'm quickly going to open some macro keys right here to be able to comfortably do this. So I'll just group this and take a look at what's possible with the layout constraints, with the manual ones. So I'm just trying basically every configuration. So what of course makes sense is that when the width, and that's a word I simply can't pronounce, sorry about that, if the width of an element is fixed, it of course can only have a fixed margin to one of the two sides of the document. So right now it has a right margin, so if I enable responsive resize right here, it will stick to the right margin. If I set this to the left margin, it will presumably stick to the left margin, exactly. So if I move the left one, it stays fixed there. If we now remove this fixed width, it will scale with the document. So it presumably takes a specific percentage of the document when it scales without fixed sizing. Same probably applies to the height. I think I understand what's happening. So if it is fixed to the top and bottom, it will apparently retain this pixel size right here. However, if it is not fixed right here, what happens then? Okay, I believe then it retains a percentage to fit this. I'll have to check about that, but presumably that's what happens. Yeah, so it obviously moves down, and I assume that this percentage below it simply stays the same throughout the scaling process. Alright, so that of course gives us some understanding of how this works. And so the things we apparently have as potential states would be just for horizontal right now, but the same applies for vertically as well. We can have basically no fixed width and percentage to both sides. We can have fixed to one of the sides and no fixed width, so a percentage to one side, a fixed pixel count to the other. Let's see. Yeah, that's apparently... Oh, is this resizing? Yes, I think it's resizing from the looks of it. Or is it now 780? Oh, I think the group isn't... Yeah, it's resizing. So I again assume this is a specific percentage on this side. Maybe the documentation says something about that. So fixed both, so it always implies, yes, holds the node position at a fixed percentage of the parent's width. So yeah, that's what I assumed basically from experimenting around with it. And then we can have both sides fixed, so a fixed pixel count to both sides. And we might have a fixed width, which then implies that it can only be fixed to one side or to no side, which means that it remains in the same percentage position but retains its size. All right, so basically my idea right now is that instead of just being able to adjust how it will scale in the future, you can actually set these values. So if you have this fixed to one side, for example to the right side, you can actually enter this 540 pixel value, and by that get the how shall I put it, enter the exact layout system of this node. So for example, I think I need this even bigger. Maybe I should just have made the text smaller, but well, let's just handle it like this. Group these two, move them up. So basically my idea right now would be that you have this node represented here as a square, and then you will have, you can set the constraints for this node, and scaling is absolutely not working for me right now, so let's move this smaller and then everything will look a bit better. So my idea right now would be that you basically have this node represented in this dialog box, and then right here you can enter, for example, 20 pixels and say ...50% to the top. And maybe, well, I should either center all of them or I should center none of them, probably. So let's for now do it like this and say 20 pixels to the left as well. And possibly, yeah, like, I don't know, can there be an auto state? Yeah, there can be an auto state. If the height is a fixed height, then down here it would be auto. So this would actually be disabled if the height of the element should be fixed. So possibly we'll have some sort of locking mechanism for the width and height. So just for the dimensions of the node that whose layout gets adjusted. And yeah, so let's just try to do this. I'll use the icons for design plugin by EM Software to possibly add some icons right here to add these lockable states, hopefully. Yeah, we have these locks. So for example, we could have this closed lock, in this case for the height of the element, because the height should be fixed. And we have an open lock for possibly the width of the element. So maybe make this clear like that, and yeah, let the line go like that, just to symbolize these states. And then these locks, you can click them and presumably get the ability to adjust the values there. So basically what we have here would be, I'll just group these things logically to have at least somewhat of an of a usable document right here. So just grouping these things, grouping all of those, grouping it with its background, and then grouping all of them. So the state we have right here, if we now group this into, what has happened now exactly? So just grouping it with this. Ah, okay, possibly. Yeah, it's moved into the foreground. So let's do this differently. Let's quickly group this with this, with this, with this, and then we can group these. And now we will apply to this inner element what presumably this configuration in our dialog box means. So we would have 50% from the top, 20 pixels to each side. So something like that. To the bottom it's auto. So yeah. So the height will be retained, presumably. And so if we now set this to the bottom, it is auto with a fixed height and a variable width. So if we now resize the container, this is basically the behavior this would do. Or not, apparently. Let's just disable responsive resize for this inner one right there. So the thing that's irritating me right now is, since this inner element, should probably be like that, and then like that maybe. If you now do it like that, it's not working either. So I'm currently feeling like I'm failing to understand how the layout system of Adobe XD is working exactly. So if I have this rectangle right here, and I put another rectangle in here, and I now group these two, give them responsive resize, and the inner one has manual settings of basically having a fixed height, no fixed width constraints of pixels to the left and right, and to the top and bottom, basically auto where the top one has 50 pixels. So basically like that. And that should now be retained with 50 I didn't set the top constraint there, but now it should. Yeah, that's basically the behavior we want with this configuration on the left. But nope, that's not the configuration we want apparently, because no, we need this top 50%, so it retains its position at 50% from the top. The problem is that it doesn't really. So that's not quite how the layout system in Adobe XD works, so we'll have to revise a bit how our UI might look like. Say we leave these percentages out. And basically leaving it blank infers an automatic mode. That would be some option I'd see right now. That might be an option. So let's just quickly jump into prototyping this plugin with some code. So trying to actually use it. I've already made a few adjustments, like installing the latest version of the TypeScript definitions, actually the versions from the XD 2019 updates branch, which is currently not in the master branch, since we're still fixing some smaller issues there, but now we can just increase this minor version, which is very important since these APIs are only available from Adobe XD version 29 and above. And now inside our main JS, we can first try to possibly set these constraints like we have them in here to see if that works with the current APIs. So now let's take a quick look at the documentation right here. So we have these horizontal constraints, which can be an object. Both fields must be provided together when setting this property, so size and position have to be set together. All right. Fixed left, size fixed. All right, so basically the thing we have to do now is, first of all, we have to set these constraints, but then also resize the element to fit these constraints we enter in the plugin with our pixel values. So that's the idea right now. If anyone is now newly watching the stream, we are currently building a plugin to more comfortably work with the responsive resize tools inside Adobe XD, which the capability to edit the options for that are brand new in the Adobe XD APIs. And now we're basically building a plugin where you can enter pixel values and set the constraints to each side and then update a node to reflect it inside a document. So now we'll for example, build this system right here. So I'll add some text here once again, and possibly auto as well, just for demonstration purposes, which would then reflect this option right here, or relative or something like that. So first of all, we have this position property right here we have to set. So let's go into our code and quickly iterate over all selected nodes. So for const node of selection dot items. So for each node of these items, we want to adjust the node's options. And now, first of all, we want to set the horizontal constraints. So node.horizontalConstraints equals a new object with a position, and the typings have a typo apparently there, so that's something I'll have to fix quite soon. Position. So let me very quickly fix that in the TypeScript definitions right now. We'll go over to the Adobe XD typings and fix this typo right now before I forget it. So inside types, we have this position thing, which is presumably in the scene graph. And in there, we can hopefully edit this file and just edit it right there. So where are we? Not in the matrix, not in the color, scale cover, scale behavior, indent, no, that's the image fill. But we need the scene node, so right here. And then we have towards the bottom, if I'm correct, the plugin data, shared plugin data. There we have this blend mode things, and then we have this positional these constraints. So here it is. This has to be position. Is it wrong here as well? Yes, it is. This has to be position. Yeah, better. Fixed a typo. All right. So, now that that's committed, let's quickly reinstall the TypeScript definitions right here. So rerun npm install, and then this position property of this object should no longer be recognized as something wrong, hopefully. Giving it just a few seconds here. Right, and now if we take a look, maybe it has to re-index it or something. Let's quickly see if it has worked. So in the add types Adobe XD types scene graph, we should no longer find a position, but we do, so it didn't actually recognize that it could update. So let's just manually fix that right now in here as well. So I'm just going down there, the scene node list, the matrix, the factors, Haskell, color will only take a few more seconds, hopefully. So, right here somewhere, fixed when scrolling, hassling, content plugin data, blend mode, and here it is. So, position and position. And now this should look better. Yeah. So we have this position, which according to the documentation has to be cnode.fixed left, fixed right, fixed both, or position proportional. In our case, we want to have it fixed both, presumably, because we want it fixed on both sides to 20 pixels. So cnode dot fixed both, and we of course have to import the cnode right here. So constant destructuring it and calling it cnode equals require the scene graph module. Yeah, and now we have this fixed both inside the scene node, and now we of course also need the size, and this in our case has to be not fixed, whatever that is inside the constant. We'll have to look that up, but for now, since we have this lock open basically in our simulated UI, we want the size to not be fixed. So not size fixed, but size resizes, it is called, according to the docs. So size resizes. And now, presumably, if we run this plugin, at least this aspect of it should get set correctly. So reloading the plugins right now and rerunning our plugin, which I'll have to find right here. So is it actually here somewhere? Constraints that are right here. So if I rerun it, yeah, it actually set it correctly. So the only thing we have to do now, or only thing of course is relative, but yeah, the thing we have to do now is make sure that it actually basically accepts these constraints we've input into a dialog for this plugin, which of course we'll develop later. This is just basically prototyping, trying whether the things work how I want them to work, in a sense. So, 20 pixels, and we basically have to resize this element so that it has these 20 pixels. First of all, of course, we have to figure out how we can determine the current margins. So let's just write some code for that. Presumably, we can just take the global bounds of both our node and the parent node and compare their values, and like that determine the margins, the current margins, and based on that, or do we actually need to do that? Let me think for a second. Let's just try to do it directly. So node dot move in parent coordinates. What does this take? A delta x, a delta y. No, that's not exactly what I need. I need a place in parent coordinates. But I will also presumably need a resize. All right, let's calculate our margins, because this will probably make our life a whole lot easier. So our node left coordinate, which is a constant in this scope, will be our current node dot global bounds. We can actually use the global bounds here, this will help us out a bit, dot x, the node right coordinate will be the node.globalBounds.x plus node.globalBounds.width. And now we only have to figure out... oh, wait a second. We presumably do not need the left... do we? I'm currently trying to think how we'll do this the most efficient way. So let's just say node.resize, and we basically need our parent container width. So node.parent. Presumably local bounds in this case. Or, yeah, probably when we rotate this, this will get a whole lot messier, so we'll have to use local bounds, unfortunately. Although I don't really want to do that, so. Alright, yeah, node must not necessarily have a parent. So, all of this only makes sense if a node has a parent. So, if node.parent. So, like that, and then we can check the local bounds of the parents and the width, and now our new width we have to give our child object is basically our current constraints, or no, the width of the parent element minus our current constraints. So basically this parent width. Minus our two constraints, which are in this case 20 pixels plus 20 pixels. So I'll just write it like this so we later understand better what it does when we change this to actually dynamic code. Or maybe not later, maybe in one of the next days. I'm not really sure about that as of yet. Yeah, so we have that. This should be our new width. And then we also need the position, which will presumably be new position. Which will on the X be our 20 and on the Y be our node dot local bounds, presumably, I hope, or is there bounds in parent, that's better, bounds in parent dot Y. And now let us quickly apply this translation to this node. So node.resize, no, not reset to auto constraints, we actually want to resize, yeah. Okay, it takes a width and a height as separate arguments, that's unfortunate, but alright. So new width and node.localBounds.height, presumably. Yeah, I assume this is in local coordinates. And we also have to use place in parent coordinates with our new position. Oh no, we first need a registration point, which we will say x0 and y0. Let's just try that. And the parent point has to be this new position. All right, let's quickly try how that works. I assume it has been installed correctly. Yes, I believe it has. And now let's reload this. Let's mess up our configuration right here once again. And after reloading the plugins, if we now run the plugin, it absolutely did not do what I wanted it to do. Although it was only the placement that didn't work. Everything else worked as expected. It was just the placement which did not really work. So let me quickly take a look in the docs how this registration point works. Maybe this is a shortcut for transform point. Position of the node's upper left corner in its parent's coordinate space. Maybe we just have to use this as a registration point. I don't believe so, but just trying this. Top left in parent. Just trying it because really dealing with the coordinate space is always kind of tricky, especially when it's kind of late in the day. Okay, nope, I'm pretty sure it's not, this is not what we wanted. So yeah, local center point maybe? The position of the node's center point in its own local coordinate space, useful as an argument in rotate around. No, that's not really what I need. I need something for the resizing. Maybe we have some example code for that even, which I would be extremely thankful for right now. Yeah, node resize. No, we need place and parent coordinates. That was it. Place in parent coordinates. Yeah. So, point in this node's local coordinate space to align with the parent point. Okay. So I understand what it is now. So, I understand once again, thankfully. The node bounds equals the local bounds, all right? Node bounds in its own local coordinates, all right? So basically, that's apparently how we can determine the top left, which is, if you ask me, slightly ridiculous, but alright. Nothing I can do about that. So let's just try that. So we have x equals node dot local bounds dot x and y dot y equals wait a second, we probably could use some destructuring here, right? Yeah, believe so, if we now just use node.localbounds. This should work, right? So if we now reload our plugins, that did not work how I wanted it to. Right, what are they doing here? Place this node's top left corner at the center point of its parent. So node parent center point, yeah, that's all right. So we have this point where we want to set it to. We do have that. Now node bounds equals local bounds, node top left, and the parent center. Okay, there's something I'm not seeing right now. So this new position should presumably be something like that. Oh no, Y was working basically correctly. X20. So what is it doing right now? So if I use this, it moves it 100 pixels to the left. It is basically 200 pixels wide. Yeah, let's just quickly get this into a size where it's easier to debug. So this is 200 pixels wide, 60 pixels to each side. All right, and if I now run this plugin, let's quickly save this document, reload the plugins and run this plugin, it gets moved exactly 100 pixels to the left. Which makes me believe that it takes something like the half of this number, the half value of this number, which is 200 pixels, because it moves 100 pixels to the left. I'm not quite sure why as of yet, but yeah, that's something we'll have to figure out next. So, yeah, let's take another look at the documentation for the coordinate spaces. Live coding is always one of the harder things to do correctly or efficiently, of course. So, sizes and distances are dependent units here, right. If you need a bounding box that encapsulates, all right. Logo bounds to get the true top left of a node. All right. So, let's just take a look here. We resize it, and the resizing works correctly. We've seen that. So, we just have to figure out how to do this more efficiently. So, let's just explicitly set the x value right now. So let's say x minus 100, just for experimentation purposes. So comma, yeah. Let's just play around with it a bit to try to understand the behavior. Yeah, now it moves. Okay, this is interesting. Now it got stuck to basically x0 in a sense. So that would have been what I would have expected like that. Oh yeah, alright. So basically we need minus 120 here. Whatever that is, but we need this node to be a bit smaller actually. Let's mess this thing up a bit again and rerun our constraint setter. Yeah, now I believe it is working correctly. Okay. So, how do we get minus 120 here? So, let's quickly console log a bunch of stuff. For example, our node local bounds, our node local center point, our node top left and parent. Let's quickly log these things to the developer console inside XD and see what gets logged to hopefully figure out how to correctly do this. So we'll just reload the plugins really quickly, rerun the plugin on this object. Okay, we have 0, 0, 140 and 140. Interesting. Nothing that really quickly would get us to 120, unfortunately, for the moment. Yeah, let me. So, place in parent coordinates. Move the node to the given point in its local coordinates. Displace the point given point to its parent's coordinates. Displaced at a given point in its parent's coordinates, taking into account any rotation on this node, etc. For an overview of and so on and so on, let me just quickly copy this code over and see if this actually positions it at the top left corner of plugin, because frankly right now I do not believe it will. Right, let's just do it like that. Reload the plugin. Yeah, it has basically placed this node's top left corner at the center point of its parent. Yeah, it's doing that, alright. And if I now say basically x0 and y0, what does it do now? Ah, okay, so apparently x0 and y0, so it's this is not the position. In this case, let us quickly calculate this top left-hand position, or top left corner, which will basically be the parent's so basically parent dot local bounds. That should work, so or node dot parent local bounds. And now if we rerun this plugin, it should go to the top left corner. Yes. And now move it outside. Yeah, because the group is its parent. That makes sense. But basically it's working right now. So that is really great. So now that that's out of the way, we can once again use our own code right here. So like that. And it's actually, we need this target position to be node. So yeah, we just have to adjust the target position actually, and that will be node.parent.localbounds.x plus the value, and once again right here, node parent local bounds dot y plus this. Maybe now it'll work, hopefully. But it's we're still having this code at the bottom right here, and this resize can get removed right now. And if we now reload our plugins and rerun the plugin, that looks much better. And if we now resize it, it actually has this behavior we wanted. So this is already looking great. The only issue right now is that if we rerun this plugin now multiple times, it actually offsets this a few times, but we can probably change that since we, or no, let's do this right now. So bounds in parent apparently already takes this into account, so we can just leave this like that. If we now rerun the plugin. It should retain for now its horizontal. No, horizontal is the wrong word here. It's a vertical position, but apply these constraints as we have set them. And yeah, that's what it's doing. So now the constraints are applied, and basically it will keep to these 20 pixels to the left and the right side. Right, great. That's basically the first hurdle of developing this plugin already done. So that's a great first step. And yeah, I believe we will do one more thing and then we'll call it a day for today, just because I'm slowly but surely getting kind of tired, and coding while you're tired is not one of the best ideas, because you usually just are mad at yourself when you're looking at your code the next time that you've coded while you're extremely tired, because it usually isn't really good, especially when it comes to math-heavy operations, like here, dealing with these translations of scene notes. So, yeah, not really the best idea to do too much about that right now. But what I possibly want to do is already add a very rudimentary modal dialogue with which we can try this whole thing with setting it dynamically. So let's just install the XD dialog helper, which is another library I've developed and released open source under the MIT license for everyone to use, which makes it much easier than it is usually to to add modal dialogues to plugins for Adobe XD. And yeah, okay, it's already installed. I just wanted to say I'll drink a tiny bit, but I'll drink something anyway right now, so I'll be back in a second. Alright, and back I am. So we've now installed the XD dialog helper, which means we can make, this is already an asynchronous function, this is great, and we can now require our dialog helper. And we can actually display a dialog before everything else. So we'll say const results equals await dialog helper dot show dialog, and that's basically the only function this helper has. We have to pass it an ID of the dialog. In this case we'll call it constraint options. It has a title. We already defined this title right here, so adjust constraints. Adjust constraints. It has some contents, which will be an array, which we'll set in a second. And we can pass it some options. For example, we can define the OK button text. Right here we said this would be apply. So yeah, let's just set that. And also, do we want to set something else right here? We do not really need validation. Maybe some custom width of possibly 480 pixels. Sounds about good. The cancel button text is cancel by default, so that can stay the way it is. And everything else we don't have to worry about for now. And now let's add some contents to this dialog. First content type will be of the type dialoguehelper.types.text, which is basically just our explanatory text. And we will have some label, which will for now be our lorem ipsum text, because we don't have any real description for it right now. Let's give it an ID, which can be, for example, label description, and yeah, what else does it need? Label type HTML attributes, right. So it doesn't need any additional HTML attributes, but we'll just set them so that the auto-completion is happy with us. And now, if we just save this and reload the plugin right here and run the plugin, you can see that actually a dialog window opens, which includes our text, our apply, and some description text. And now we can actually begin to add a few text fields or text inputs. So we'll type is of the type dialoguehelper.types. Could actually make this a slider. Yeah, let's do that, right? So we'll have a slider. It has the ID of margin left, maybe. And, oh, this is a margin left. And it has a label, which we'll call margin left. And it has a current value of 20. It has, it is required. So that has to be true. We are in JavaScript here, not in HTML. So the unit will be pixels. And the HTML attributes, do we need ones? Yeah, we'll need a minimum of 0 and a max of, say, 100. Right. Add a comma right here. Add a comma right here. And if we now save this and reload our plugin and rerun this thing, we can now adjust our margin left. And if we click apply, still the same margins that are preset will get used, but yeah, that's something we can do in a second, or change in a second. So yeah, let's just copy this over one more time and say this will be our margin right. Basically the same thing, just for the right side. And after that, we have these results, and we can now preview these results by just logging them right here. And what you'll be able to see in a second when I open this back up inside Adobe XD and I rerun this plugin, set our values, click apply, you can now see that we actually get these values right here. And we can now, of course, and they are in an object. You can see this ID actually matches the ID we've given these fields in the code. And so we can now just use them instead of these 20 pixels in our code. And just like that, we have some dynamic options for our plugin. So let's just say here, results dot margin left, results dot margin right, bounce x will be results dot margin left, y value will be untouched for now, and I believe this should already do the trick. So for example, if we now run the plugin and say 30 pixels to the right, it did not work, unfortunately. All right, what did we do wrong? So let's just check that the resizing is working. So let's just say console log u width, and the parent width, and the parent width minus our u width. And once again, that's a term I simply cannot pronounce. It's one of the very few English terms that I, for the life of me, cannot pronounce, really. So let's rerun our plugin. Say 40 pixels. It actually did something. Now it worked for some reason. Maybe I just had to reload it one more time. I don't know. Let's just mess this up once again. The thing right now is that it has to stay inside our bounds. So the problem right now is that if we did it like that, what you can see here is now our outer bounds of this parent are, how shall I put it, outside the actual bounds of the parent. So that's one bug we still have in there, but if we now take it in here, rerun the constraint setter, set it to maybe 34 pixels to the left and 11 pixels to the right. We actually get about 34 and 11 pixels. Currently it's still using floating point values, so values that can have decimal places for these values, but that of course is something we can fix really, really easily. So what you can see here is like we have 33.799 and 10.551, and the only thing we have to do to change this really is just, for example, say results dot margin left equals math dot round, I believe it was, results dot margin left, and do exactly the same thing for the right margin. So right, and it should have reinstalled successfully, hopefully. So if I now rerun the plugin, so I've reloaded and now I'm rerunning the plugin. Yeah, it's setting exact values, and if we look into the console, yeah, we set them before we printed out these results, so that's why it still says these floating numbers here. But you can see right below our second console log, which was our calculated width and the parent width, and the difference of them both is actually in whole numbers, and so that's presumably what we want right here. We could also right here in our HTML attributes just say that the step should be 1, and that should also change this behavior, as now presumably if I rerun the plugin, we can only set it to specific step sizes. So yeah, it's working perfectly right now. And so the next step, of course, would be to add this select box to say whether it's fixed to one side or how it basically should behave. But that, to be completely honest, is something I'm not really capable of doing anymore today. So yeah, I believe we'll just conclude the stream right now and right here. Just as a recap, a quick recap, today we've done our first steps of creating this plugin. We prototyped a bit how this plugin should work, can work, etc. We then experimented around with how these capabilities of the APIs can be used, and are now at an early prototype stage for our plugin, where we can set our margins to different sides, in this case for now just left and right, click apply, and it applies these margins and fixes it to these sides, so that in responsive resizing it will retain exactly these margins. And if I now rerun the plugin, and for example say to the left it should have no margin and to the right maybe 40 pixels, and redo this, everything still works, so this retains its 40 pixels to the right and 0 pixels to the left. Yeah, I'm not exactly sure when the next opportunity for me to stream developing the plugin will be. Hopefully it will be in the next few days. I'll of course keep you updated on all the different channels where you already got the information about this event today. So on Twitter, or probably on the official Adobe XD plugin developer forums, which just a small shout out here, if you are a plugin developer and do not have an account in these developer forums, that is forums.adobexdplatform.com, please create an account, write a short introduction in the intro section. This is the one place where you basically get answers to all your questions. I can really highly, highly recommend it. It is one of the greatest developer communities I've worked with so far, so there's basically no salty behavior there whatsoever. There are no questions where an answer would be read the fucking manual or something like that. So yeah, it's really, it's a great community. It's a very warm, welcoming community. So please, if you're a plugin developer or just want to become one, check out these forums and create an account there. Here you can see I also announced this live stream, so I'll probably inform about the next live stream right here. Also, yeah, I'll now quickly commit all these changes. So that is, let's see, initial steps towards our plugin, and I'll push them to the GitHub repository of this plugin. So if you find the time and the motivation to do so, please feel free to just continue developing the plugin, maybe submit some ideas in the pull request or something like that. Right here, I'll quickly paste the link here in the Twitch chat as well to these to this GitHub repository. So there's that. It's really easy. It's just in my GitHub profile, pklashka. It's the XD plugin layout constraint setter. So yes, it was uploaded 1 minute ago. Perfect. So that's our current code, and so it is here that we now actually conclude the stream. I thank you so much for watching. Hopefully we'll do this again in the near future and continue developing this plugin. If you have any ideas, please feel free to submit them via GitHub, via the contact form on my website, via whatever place you feel most comfortable with. And yes, until then, thank you so much for watching. My name is Pablo Glaschka, and have a great day, evening, or what time it is, wherever you are.